Welcome to our lecture online. Our next JE main problem deals again with mechanics and in particular with Pascal's principle. So let's read it together and see what it is. A hydraulic press can lift 100 kilograms when a mass M is placed on the smaller piston. It can lift X number of kilograms when the diameter of the larger piston is increased by 4 times and that of the smaller piston is decreased by 4 times, keeping the same mass M on the smaller piston. So when you read this, it's a little bit confusing, so a diagram might help. Now, they didn't give us a diagram, so quickly let's draw a diagram of what we're thinking is happening. So we have something like this, where we have a small piston and we have a large piston. Fluid down here. So here we can say that this, let's call that A1, and over here the cross-sectional area of piston, the larger piston, let's call it A2. Now on the larger piston they put 100 kilograms and on the smaller piston they put M. And so the principle, and that's always the key, right, is to understand the principle. The principle is that the pressure at 1, right here, must equal the pressure at 2. And that is what we call Pascal's principle. When there's pressure put on a fluid, the pressure distributes evenly everywhere throughout the fluid. So that's the concept we have to deal with. Now, we know that pressure equals force over area. So that would be F1 over A1 is equal to F2 over A2. And then, of course, if you replace F by the weight of this, that would be mg over A1 equals 100g over A2. And of course, g's cancel out, and now we have a relationship between m, the 100, the A1, and the A2. So what we could do here is we can then write the equation like this. We can simply say that A2 over A1 is equal to 100 over M, and then we can call it initial because we're going to change the cross-sectional area of the two pistons, the large piston and the small piston. Now, if you understand Pascal's principle more at a conceptual level, we know that the smaller we make this, the less force it takes to lift up a heavy object. So if we make this smaller, it essentially increases the efficiency or the effectiveness of the press. And then if we make this bigger, again, that will accomplish the same thing. If we keep this the same, but we make this piston bigger, it allows us to lift a heavier object because we have a larger cross-sectional area. So essentially what we need to do is if we double the size of this area, we can lift twice as much mass. If we decrease this to half the area, again, we can lift twice the mass there as well. So we can actually solve this problem rather quickly. So notice that D1, the diameter here, D1 final equals 1/4 D1 initial. So what we're doing here is we're reducing the size to 1/4 the initial diameter. And so since we know that area is equal to pi over 4 times D squared, what this then means is we can say that area 1 final is therefore equal to this number squared, so it would be 1/16 area initial, area 1 initial. So we actually reduce the area by a factor of 16 by reducing the diameter by a factor of 4. On the other side, we can say that D2 final equals 4 times D2 initial, and so therefore we can say that area 2 final equals 16 times area 1 final. So we can then say that since we reduce the cross-sectional area here by a factor 16, that allows us to lift 16 times as much mass or weight, and since we're increasing the area here by a factor 16, we can also increase the amount of mass by 16. So essentially, the mass we can lift now here, that would be x times 100, and the x would be 16 because of the area of the first one, times 16 because the change in the area of the second one, so it reduces by 16, that means we can lift 16 times as much mass, and we increase this by 16 so we can lift again 16 times as much mass, so it's 16 times 16 times 100, That's of course 256 with two more zeros, or 25,600 kilograms can be lifted because we went to 1/4 the diameter, or 1/16 the area. So we can say that we have 1/16 area 1, which is now the area 1 new. So the area 1 final equals the area 1 initial divided by 16. And here we can say that area 2 final is equal to 16 times area 2 initial. So we increase the area by 16, decrease the area by 16. That's essentially a factor of 256. So it can lift 256 times the original mass of 100 kilograms, meaning 25,600. So that's probably the best way to look at it, the easiest, fastest way, because otherwise when you start working out equations, it takes too long and you lose too much time. So it's probably better to think about it conceptually, and that's the way it is done.